Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_037_DIAB where you save it. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_038_DIABM and click the save button. Now we need to start to grid our roof, and we're going to grid some temporal layer that can help us to grid the roof fast. When we don't, we couple up the roof into one layer and delete the unnecessary layer. To do this, go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer properties. This brings the layer properties manager. Click the new layer, rename this layer to roof, and click the color swatches. Change its color to the index color 98. Click OK. Click the new layer button again. Let's create another temporal 3D so that we can use the hide the one of the 3D wall while we are modeling at the base. Then when we complete, we bring it back. Afterwards, we can move all the objects to the appropriate layer and delete the wrong layer. Rename this layer to 3D walls. Click the color swatches and give it a different color from the original color. Select the index color 21 and click OK. Now select layer 0, click the new layer button and rename this layer to R1, rename this other layer to R2, click the new icon again, rename this layer to R3, continue until you get R8. When you create a new layer, you want to create another layer, all you need to do, press the comma on the keyboard, AutoCAD starts a new layer. Rename it to R6, press the comma key, rename it to R7, press the comma key, rename it to R8. Now select the R1 layer, click the color switches, and select the index color number 1, click OK. Select the R2 layer and change its color to the index color number 2. Select the R3 layer and change the color to the index color number 3. Select the R4 layer and change its color to the index color number 4. Select the R5 layer and change its index color number 5. Select the R6 layer and change its color to the index color number 6. Select the R7 layer. Change its color to the index color 241, click OK. Select the R8 layer and change its color to the index color 243, click OK. Close the layer properties manager. Now select this solid, click the down arrow and select the 3D walls 2. Now press escape, go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the freeze command. Freeze this layer and freeze the first floor slab. Press escape to get out of the command. Now if we want to draw object to a 2D object, we can only draw a 2D object in the X and Y plane. For example, if you want to draw a circle command, you can only draw this circle in the X and Y plane. Now type ELIF on your keyboard. Press enter. At the enter new elevation prompt, type 3000 on your keyboard. Press enter. At the enter new default thickness, press enter to accept the 0. Now if I go to the home tab and select the circle command, add specifying center point prompts, add specifying center point for circle or 3p 2p tangent radius prompt, type 0,0, press enter. Now let's specify a radius of 1500 mm, press enter. Click the right face of the vehicle. You see the circle is above the X and Y plane. So let's continue with this elevation until we finish designing the roof that goes on the face of this solid. Select the circle, this circle, and hit delete on your keyboard. Pull down the shift key to orbit around. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the freeze command. Freeze this slab and freeze this object, freeze all of this stuff. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the 2D polyline command. At the space where starting point bumped, use the endpoint object and snap to this vertex. Turn on the polar tracking and click this down arrow and make sure that the 45 degree angle alignment is checked. Click on the drawing area to close the dialog box. Snap to this vertex. Continue. Snap to this vertex. Press enter to end the command. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, click down arrow and select the R1. Select the line command and draw a line. Click. Now we need to change the R1 layer because the R1 has the same color as the cabbage layer. Go to the layer properties manager and click the color switches. Change the R1 color to, select the index color 98 and click OK. Close the layer properties manager. Now select this line and this line. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. AutoCAD isolate this object. Go to the view control, click the custom view and select top. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 750 millimeter. Press enter. Select this line and offset it out. Press escape. Go to the home tab, drop panel, and select the line command. Start the line at this vertex and this vertex. Press enter. Start the line again. Draw a line from here to here. Press enter. Start the line command from here to here. Press enter. Start the line command from here to here. Start the line command from this midpoint and to this midpoint. Press enter. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current command. Click on this object to make the cabbage layer as the current layer. Select the line command and draw a line from this point and join it to this point. Now move into this direction and click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Select this two line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At specifying first point of mirror line, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this line. Move into this direction and use the polar angle and snap. Press enter. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Fillet this line and this line. Select this line and explode it. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Start the line from this point. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape. Fillet, select the fillet command. Fillet this line to this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, click this down arrow and select the extend command. Select this object, press enter, and extend this line. Extend this line. Press escape. We need to adjust this line. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Start the line command from this point. Move the mouse cursor. Okay, the line is in the right place. Press escape. Select this polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Start the line at the midpoint of this line. Move the mouse cursor into 45 degree and click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and this line. Select this line and this line. Select this line and this line. Let's escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. And specify offset distance from type 750 mm and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the line command and draw a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Press enter. Draw a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Now go to the view cube and click on this vertex. Type DI on your keyboard and press enter. At specify face point prompt, click on this area. Move the mouse cursor and click on this area. 6072. Go and bring the window calculator. Click into the chat box and type CAL and select calculator. If you use Windows 7, the chat bar will be here. Now go to AutoCAD and press the F2 key. Select this figure. Highlight the figure. Control C. Go to the calculator. Control V. Now divide this object into 2. Equals 2. Then multiply by 7.5. Multiply this figure by 0.75. Equals 2. Copy this figure. Back to AutoCAD. Go to the home tab, drop panel and select the line command. At specifying start point prompt, click on this point. Turn on the auto mode and move the mouse cursor to the Z direction. Orbit to get a better orientation and move the mouse cursor into the Z direction. Type 0 on your keyboard and backspace it. Now hold down the control key and type V on your keyboard to paste the figure. Press enter. AutoCAD draw the points for you. Now type DI on your keyboard, press enter. At the specified first point prompt, start at this corner and move the mouse cursor and snap to the end point of this line. Press F2. The figure is 2000 2119. Highlight and copy. Go to the calculator. Control V. Multiply by 0.75 equals to. Now right click, copy, go to the drawing area, start the line command. At specifying first point prompt, click on this area, move into the Z direction, backspace and hold down your control key. Type letter V on your keyboard to place the figure. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. Use this as a base point to copy this line into this area. Press escape. Let's try to determine the height of this other face. Type DI on your keyboard. Press enter. At specifying face point prompt, click on this endpoint and move the mouse cursor and click off this endpoint. Press F2 on your keyboard. Select the distance. Highlight this distance. Control C. Go to the calculator. You can right click and paste. Multiply by 0.75 equals to. Now right click, copy, back to AutoCAD, start the line command. As specified in first point prompt, use the midpoint or endpoint object snap and snap from this point. Move into the Z direction. Press the backspace twice and hold down the control key. Type V on your keyboard to place the figure. Press enter. Press enter to end line command. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. Copy this line into a new location. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object from, select this line. Use a window selection to move all these objects to the cabbage layer. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, layer panel and select the make current command. At the select object whose layer will be current, click on this object. Now hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit so that drawing can stay slightly. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow, press the push pin and select the 3D polyline command. At specify face point prompt, click on this vertex and click on this vertex. This vertex, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Click on this vertex and this vertex and this vertex. Type C on your keyboard and press enter. Hold down the shift key to zoom. Press enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Now start the polyline from this point and this point. Move the mouse cursor and click on this vertex. Now move and select this vertex. Move and click on this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, and select this endpoint. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Now select the 3D polyline that you just drew. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface Panel, and click the Plan. AutoCAD convert the object into surface. Now select the surface and hit Delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab and click the down arrow. Press the Push key. Click on the 3D polyline command. Start the 3D polyline from this point to this point, this point, and this point. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Press Enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Start from this point, this point. Use the endpoint of this line and use the endpoint of this line. Type C on your keyboard and press enter. Now type Oops on your keyboard and press enter to bring the surface that you just deleted. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to get a better orientation. When you are drawing 3D space, make sure that you are always in a better orientation to see your 3D model clearly. Select this 3D polyline, orbit around, go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface Panel, and click the Plan command. AutoCAD convert this surface into plan. Select this 3D polyline, this 3D polyline, go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface Panel, and select the Plan command. AutoCAD convert the surface to plan. Now we need to create one more 3D surface. Go to the Home tab and click the down arrow next to the start a 3D command. Click on this vertex, move the mouse cursor and use the endpoint object snap to this endpoint of this line, snap to the endpoint of this line, snap to this endpoint. Type C on your keyboard and close the figure. Press enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Start the command from this point and turn on the auto off the auto mode. Snap at the endpoint of this vertical line. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this line. Click on this vertex. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Now select both 3D polyline. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Solid Edit Panel, and select the Plan command. Go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, click the down arrow after the layer and select the Previous. AutoCAD puts you in the previous state of the layer. Click the Previous again. Each time you click, AutoCAD move one step to the previous setting of the layer that you specified. Now the first roof is being created, but we need to trim this roof. To do that, go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, click the down arrow and select the first floor slab. Draw the first floor slab layer. Press click to the drawing area to close the window. Now go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, and click the Make Current button. Click on this cabbage layer. Now select the slab, right click, isolate object. Now go to the Draw Home tab, Draw Panel, and select the 2D polyline command. Orbit around and start the 2D polyline from this vertex. Continue and select this vertex, press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, and select the freeze command. Freeze the slab, press escape. Select the freeze command again, freeze this wall, press escape. Now go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling Panel, and select the Extrude command. Select this line, press enter. Move the mouse cursor up to extrude this line up. Now change the workspace to 3D Modeling Workspace. go to the workspace, which is click down and select 3D modeling workspace. In the 3D modeling workspace, go to the surface tab, edit panel, turn off the surface associativity, click the trim command, trim surface command, select this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, press enter. Select this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, press enter. Trim off this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface, press escape to get out of the command. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the store layer command. Now this is the result. Select this surface, this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate, hide object. Now select this line. This line must be 750 millimeters. To prove that, hover the mouse cursor into the grip. As you can see, the line is 750 millimeters. Go to the quick calc, 750 multiply by 0.75 equals to, now right click, copy, go to the drawing area, go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At specify first point prompt, click on this point, move the mouse cursor into the Z direction, press backspace twice and hold down the control key, type V on your keyboard, press enter. Press enter to end the line command. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. Select this line, press enter. We took that isolate this line. Now select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. As specifying this point prompt, use the endpoint and snap to this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 3D polyline command. Select the endpoint of this line and the endpoint of this line, this line, this line. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Now select the 3D polyline that you just created. Go to the surface tab, creation panel, and click the plan. AutoCAD convert this object into a surface. Now go to the home tab, right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the unisolate command. Now select this surface and this surface, right, this surface, right click, isolate, isolate object. Go to the surface tab, edit panel, and select the extend command. Select the edge of this surface, press enter. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Type S on your keyboard and press enter. And select the merge option. Click on this area. Hold down the shift key to orbit around. Select this surface. Hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the surface tab, edit panel, and click the trim command. Select this surface and this surface. Press enter. Select this surface, press enter. Now click on this object and trim off this. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. Select the cabbage layer to isolate it, press enter. Now go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this polyline, press enter. Move the mouse cursor up to extrude this surface up. Go to the surface tab, edit panel, and select the trim command. Make sure that your surface associativity is turned off. Select this surface and press enter. Select this face, press enter. Click to erase it. Press escape. Select this surface and hit delete. Now use a window selection to select this object. Hold down the shift key and select the surface. Hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the unisolate command. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. select this surface and select this surface. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the isolate command. Select this surface and press enter. Now select this surface, right click into the drawing area, select similar, right click, isolate, hide object. Use a window selection to select the entire object in this area. Press delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the unisolate command. Go to the custom view and select the SA isometric. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. All right, we create our first roof, but before we end up this tutorial, let's change the first roof layer's color back to the index color number one, which is red. The reason was we changed it to green because of the I don't want it to have the same color with the garbage layer. Now that we finish with it, we change it back to the original color. Click the layer properties and select the R1 layer. Click the color switches, select the index color number one, and click OK. Close the layer properties manager. We complete the first roof of our model. All right, as you can see, whatever your roof may, however complex your model will be, you can design a roof for it if you design the roof by segments. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.